Hi, I'm Clint with Flip. If you own any kind of food business, I'm sure you know there's a long list of rules and regulations when it comes to operating. Preparing food in a commercial grade kitchen or commissary is one of the requirements we get asked a lot about. That's why today I'm walking you through the ins and outs of commercial kitchens and commissaries. Make sure you stick around to the very end to learn more about the most important questions to ask when you're looking for a space. So, to start off, what is a commercial kitchen? Commercial kitchens and commissaries are commercial grade facilities licensed for food service providers to prepare and store food. Typically, you'll rent the space from a commercial kitchen or commissary. Depending on your city or county health department, you'll need to store your food and sometimes your truck at a licensed facility. That's where commercial kitchens and commissaries come in. You can find certified commercial kitchen spaces within churches, schools, hotels, retirement homes, cooking schools, and even some restaurant owners will even rent out their kitchens during off hours. Some commercial kitchens and commissaries are shared spaces where several people can book their time slots and use the group kitchen. There's also private commercial kitchens which you can access the space and the equipment 24/7, which can be great. But keep in mind, they're usually a lot more expensive. Every space is different and you'll need a kitchen with the right equipment for your type of business. For example, if you're a baker, you're probably going to need a large oven. If you teach cooking classes, you might need a studio kitchen with larger prep areas. Or if you own a food truck, you might need a secure space that you can store your truck in. So before you go out and rent a space, here's five questions you should ask if you're looking for a commercial kitchen or a commissary for your company. Number one, what's the inspection history? If you rent a kitchen that's constantly being shut down by the health department, you could lose access to it. Your business operation or reputation could be interrupted or damaged just for associating with the commissary. Probably something to be aware of, definitely something to avoid. Number two, are cleaning and disposal facilities available? Keep in mind, when you're cooking, you might use a lot of grease or oil, for example. You should make sure that the facility that you want to use has a way to safely dispose of waste that you create. Number three, do you just need the space to store food and cook, or would you prefer a commissary that can help you obtain proper permits, certifications, supplies, or truck wraps? While these services may be more expensive up front, the long-term time savings and the added expertise could make it worth every penny. Number four, does this place have time slots available for the hours that you need on a regular basis? Before you sign up or use any commercial kitchen or commissary, please make sure that it's going to be available for you when you need to use it, especially if it's a shared space. Number five, what storage space is available to you? While the commercial kitchen or commissary may have some of the equipment you need on hand, it can be really nice to have some space available for pieces that are unique to your business. Number six, what liability insurance is required? Most commercial kitchens and commissaries require you to have liability insurance and or ask that you add them as an additional insured on your policy. With Flip Insurance, you can actually add these unlimited additional insureds for free, no cost to you, and keep it very simple. Figuring out all the details when starting your food business is really overwhelming. I hope this video helps you be more confident as you search for the right space. If you found the right space and you're still missing the insurance required to rent it, click below to get a personalized quote from Flip today. If you have any questions, feel free to get in touch with us. And as always, thanks for watching.